Listen to me. I have been ordered to keep your rallies off the streets.
No, you must listen to me. The people in this city are in dire need of your assistance. Oh, you are Jacob Fry, are you not? And Miss Fry?
We're at a disadvantage, sir.
Karl Marx, much like you, I am an activist of sorts.
You've got the look of a man who wants something.
Indeed. You've done more for London citizens lately than any endeavor has accomplished in a decade. But those citizens were already well provided for. I challenge you both to help those who really need your assistance, the working people.
An interesting challenge. We accept.
Shouldn't we at least talk about these things for... Sod it. We accept.
I'm organizing a discreet meeting with some like-minded friends to discuss trades unions. Alas, the police seem to have noticed my activities. They've stuck to me like flies on Scheisse. In any case, I need you to help me get to the meeting without the interference of the police. You see? There's one of their damn spies now. tonight, sundown. The usual place.
I'll be there.
You know, I had similar problems with the police in Paris. The ally awaits us in a nearby pub. Onwards. No doubt the police already have agents stationed within. I'll wait here until the coast is clear.
Location.
1 hour.
Right you are, Mr. Marks, sir.
Stop!
I believe our work here is complete. Come, let's slip away and get to
Poor
the meeting.
Soul.
I do appreciate your assistance in this matter. Only when workers are able to assemble freely and in strength will we be able to achieve the reforms we most assuredly deserve. Might I trouble you to stay nearby until the meeting is over? I fear we may yet meet with some mischief.
Your 30 pieces, chum. Don't you worry.
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within. You fetch the gentleman back here. I would look at him and ask why he went back on his brethren.
Ah!
It seems the movement is ever doomed to be betrayed from within.
Mistake.
We're fast friends now, aren't we?
I don't like the sound of that.
Isn't that odd?
Now, what could that be? What the hell was that?
What's happening here? Some sort of scuffle over there.
Is something bad going on?
Queen's all monkey fault is all fun.
Simon, my friend, what possessed you to do this thing? Has the party not taken care of you?
Governor, at the mill, see? Any man what joins a union will be put out of work come sunup. How long will the party feed my family for?
If we do not stand together, we are lost. My heart is broken, Simon. Please go. I thank you, my friend. I hope you will continue to aid the struggle when the opportunity presents itself.
I spoke with Mr. Green, and we have discovered the location of the British Indies secret headquarters. You are to meet him. and he will give you the details. There is a foundry nearby where the Templars and BIC members have been meeting on a regular basis. Mr. Green waits for you there.
But we still don't understand why they tried to frame you.
We don't, but Mr. Green seemed to think that they're using the factory to develop something. It's a good place to start digging. Good luck.
You made it.
You found the British Indies Company hideout?
They've taken over an abandoned foundry. It's heavily fortified, and word has it, they're shipping something precious overseas.
My gut tells me that something precious is something bad.
My thoughts exactly. Go find out what they're protecting and destroy it. Maybe you'll discover why they're after Mr. Singh.
So this is where they've been keeping that sleeping gas. They can't leave London.
Trouble, I've seen it. Come on! The puppy.
They're shipping this to India? No. What do they want this for? War? I must destroy them.
I found the button! Suppose I'll head back to work.
Better see what's wrong.
I better see what that is.
Somebody get the boss! We've got a problem!
Yes, go fetch the manager. Is that Ellsworth? I'd better get a closer look.
Destroyed? How?
There's someone in the vicinity! A spy! One of those rooks, I wager!
It must be those damned renegades Singer's friends with. Who knew one caged bird could cause so much trouble?
You're caught, Ellsworth. Give up.
I knew you had something to do with this. Seize him!
Damn it. He got away. I must tell Singer this news immediately.
He can't defeat you!
What did you find out? Who's behind all of this?
You're not gonna like what I have to tell you, Your Highness. Brinley Ellsworth is behind the attacks.
Ellsworth?
He was gone before I had a chance to follow him. But we need to track him down and put an end to this before anything worse happens.
I need some time to think on this.
Thank you.
Oh, good. You're here. His Highness seems to have caught a mild case of madness this morning.
You were right when you said that this was our chance.
I was.
I propose we make a commotion. Lure out the Templar-controlled British Indies Company.
And do what? Put yourself in the line of fire?
I need to send Ellsworth a message. This won't be over until we can draw him out. This is something I must do. I will make a scene, and then you need to rock the bottom.
I've heard you Templars are a bunch of pansies.
Here we go.
Send a message to Ellsworth.
I'll do anything!
Tell him to meet me at Lambeth Cemetery tonight, and tell him to come alone.
Meet me tonight at Lambeth Cemetery. He'll never come alone, even if I ask him to.
That caused quite a commotion.
He's gone mad. Greeny was right.
He isn't mad, Jacob. He's trying to take action. To do the right thing. Oh, never mind. I'll take it from here.
Fine by me. I could use a good pint right about now.
Oh, I was expecting Jacob, but I'm glad it's you who have come.
He thinks you've gone mad.
I'm worried about you. I feel there may be spiders living behind your eyeballs.
Evie. Who's she hiding from?
What's happening?
Alert! The leader of the rocks is in the vicinity!
We're right behind you!
Serves you bloody well right.
Ah!
take a look at what I've made.
Excellent choice. Hope to see you again.
That'll certainly help quite a bit, thank you.
He's here.
I must talk to him.
Don't be absurd. This is dangerous.
Miss Fry, this is something I must do, and I must do it alone. Remain hidden. I cannot afford to have him see you.
You can't escape me forever, Your Highness. Come out and face me.
I told you to meet me here alone.
I'm not as silly as I once was, Sing. I wouldn't dare come to this meeting place alone. Not with your recently acquired friends.
I am alone, Elspeth. It doesn't have to be like this.
You can't just walk this earth like a free man. You are nothing more than a trophy. A stag's head above. You've caused enough commotion as it is. It's time to put an end to this.
If you kill me now, you will be a wanted man. Imagine the uprising when they find out the only son of Ranjit Singh has been murdered.
You think they remember you? You are a lost soul. A monarch who has abandoned his people. You are nothing.
You are such good friends.
You were no more.
Elspeth, listen. I've had enough of this. You mustn't!
This guy! He will
kill you!
This is what I was sent here for. Be done with it, girl! I shall never forfeit my own mission.
I will not allow it.
The Loggins, the company, they all wanted your silence. Whether you spare me or end me, you won't escape the fate they have planned for you.
It seems you have learnt nothing of India, of its people. But killing you? That is something I cannot do. It would make me no better than the cursed, oppressive company you work for. Yeah.
You will die as you were raised, Singh. You'll never be more than a trophy of war. We will bury you in English soil.
You have done me much good. I am heavily indebted to you both.
We are happy to help.
I fear that I cannot continue handling things in this manner. The assassin way is not my way. As helpful as you have been, this empire, this land, my people. The problem is so much bigger than death. I know I must devote my life to this cause, to put India, my home, back onto the map, return it to its people. It's a long and grueling journey, but it is something I must do, even if it takes me to my own death.
We understand, Your Highness.
But if you do change your mind, you know where to find us.
That I do. Thank you, assassins. Hopefully, we never shall meet again.
Iris Versic.
I didn't know you had a twin sister, Mr. Fry.
Evie Fry, sir. It's a pleasure.
Usually I would reciprocate the sentiment, Miss Fry, but today I'm afraid nothing will bring me pleasure.
What's troubling you, sir?
I am used to people challenging my ideas. In fact, I live for it, the cut and thrust of spirited debate. Lately, however, attacks against my reputation have taken a darker turn. Threats of violence against my person and against my colleagues. I do not wish anyone to be hurt because of my research.
You helped me with steric syrup. I am in your debt.
We help each other, sir.
My brother and I will make sure that you can continue your work in peace.
What do you know of bones?
I know how much pressure it takes to shatter, snap, or splinter one.
Thank you.
suddenly remembered I need to meet elsewhere.
Oh, perhaps he's mad.
German doctor supposed to look like anyway? Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looks like.
Go away! That's enough! I'm coming over!
Like finding a needle in a haystack, this is. Finding a need.
You better not do that again.
Holy Mary!
Wouldn't hurt to know what the bugger looked like.
This is no place for you.
A new game of the lower classes he's playing. Properly, a wound like that could fester. Oh.
Thank you.
of this?
I'm collecting you and your precious cargo for our friend Mr. Darwin. Just act naturally.
Right. So, how is your father? By which I mean my dear brother Frank, with whom I grew up, of course. Oh, splendid! Wonderful to hear! I'll do my best not to call attention to how remiss he was in forgetting to warn me about the delicate situation which brings me here today.
Like finding a needle in a haystack.
Stay back, Doctor! To know what looks like a looks like.
Are you just going to leave me here?
Dr. Schwartz?
Never got on the train.
To take this fossil to Darwin.
Yeah.
My heart hasn't stopped pounding. You have it? Wonderful. But where is Dr. Schwartz?
Most likely dead, I'm afraid. He never left Germany. At least I managed to get the fossil back.
Dear Lord, I should tell you, I was recently approached by men who sought to purchase all my research on the condition I work only for them. Obviously, I refused. Scientific knowledge cannot be bought. It belongs to everyone. Let these villains do their worst.
Young friend, today's papers carry a rebuttal of Mr. Owen's slanderous and ignorant remark.
Help me!
Hey! You!
Oh, Christ!
Thank you.
saved my life.
Yes. Now here's a question for you. Why would you attack a newsboy?
A man paid me and my mates to force newsboys to display this leaflet. Yeah, take the bloody thing and leave me alone.
This spells trouble for Mr. Darwin.
Are not apes. If the circumstances were not so grave, I'd compliment the artist on the wonderful caricature. They are fools if they believe they can stop progress.
There's some sort of scuffle over there.
All together now.
Drink. I'll get you whatever you want.
You won't be stirring up no more trouble.
Don't kill me, please. I'm bloody desperate.
Serves you bloody well right.
That's the way.
Stop that driver before someone gets me!
That's a girl. Slow down! Whoa! Walk on, girl. Doing fine, girl.
Pistols at the ready!
Let's go.
You ain't no loss to humanity. Serves you right.
Steady on. A good horse. You are.
This one won't be needing breakfast tomorrow.
Mind you.
serves you right.
Whoa now!
One less. Serves you right.
Yeah!
Easy now.
Ah, my young friend. How good it is to see you.
Fortunate, really. It would appear a highly toxic plant, which has the extraordinary effect of making people quite delirious, has been found in this very park. Yet as far as modern science is aware, no such plant exists. I fear the good people of London might be in danger. Will you investigate?
That's no ordinary plant.
Feels like I'm in an opium den.
Oh, what's happening to me?
There you go.
Well done. But you don't seem quite like yourself.
It's just as I suspected. Those noxious fumes are not being released from the flowers, but from the pots. There must be something in there. An hallucinogenic concoction of some kind. Not unlike the soothing syrup, I should think. We must dispose of it, and quickly. I believe, my young friend, that I might know just the place. Who would want to poison the population of London? Who could devise such a nefarious plan? Obviously, it can't be Dr. Elliotson. So who can it be? I'm afraid, my young friend, that some of your enemies want their toxin returned to them. Might I suggest you position our carriage directly in front of theirs? I believe the fumes will impair their ability to drive.
Stay rooted to that spot.
I knew it.
Try to keep up.
I've been there. Not fun.
Stay here.
Count on me.
Unspeakable has happened. The policeman arrested Mr. Darwin and carried him away as if he were nothing but a common criminal. That policeman, he is corrupt to the bones, I'm sure of it. I do so fear for Mr. Darwin's safety.
Miss Nightingale, do you know where they might have gone?
The policeman, he did mention a funeral. I believe I know where it is. Follow me. Poor Mr. Darwin has been through so much recently. Those people are trying to discredit a lifetime of work. It's disgraceful. And I fear Mr. Darwin is no longer the fit young man who once traveled the world. Here we are. The obsequies are taking place here. I will wait here.
And
Oi,
I might let you live.
Ah, there's no need for such brutality. What do you want from me?
Just need you to answer some questions.
Oh, you're a brash one, aren't you?
It's been said.
Bugger. What's going on?
It was all in fun, sir.
Fight me, coward! Just fight!
You're in for it now.
Between its shoulder blades.
I am here.
Get back here.
Go on. I will be waiting here. Better hurry now. You can find me here afterwards.
And shoot!
I will wait here.
We'll see about that.
Beat on him!
Lock on, sir.
be waiting here. Arrested Mr. Darwin and carried him away as if he were nothing but a common criminal.
Honestly, what it feels like when I arrest someone? What do you want from me?
Just need you to answer some questions.
Something is going on.
Oh, you're a brash one, aren't you?
It's been said.
I was just carrying out my orders.
Mercy, I beg you, I don't want to die.
Arresting an old man and dragging him off to Lord knows where is fine work indeed for a policeman. Now, sir, tell us where you have taken Mr. Darwin.
A man paid me to bring him to his secret base.
How terrible. We will need transportation.
Doing fine, girl. That's a girl.
Darwin, shall we?
I don't think that's a...
Shall we? He's very weak. We shouldn't move Mr. Darwin until I have seen to his wounds.
They're here! Attack!
Rest up, Mr. Darwin. My sister and I will be along shortly.
Well, look who's here.
We were very worried about you, sir.
You're looking spry for a fossil, sir? A man's friends are the best measure of his worth. I'm proud to count you among mine.
The dangers pass us. We need to leave, sir.
What Mr. Darwin needs now is rest. To that end, he's joining his family on the Isle of Wight.
Rest, indeed. I shall start work on my next book.
I must insist that you recuperate quietly, sir.
The acquisition of knowledge is in itself sufficiently recuperative. Go, tell her.
This is one fight I aim to avoid, sir.
Thank you for everything, my friends. Ideas, like people, can only thrive when they're free.